Hello and welcome to another episode of The Next Step. We are delighted to have with us today Rashi Wadhwani, who is a 2020 graduate from Vellore Institute of Technology in the field of computer science. She's currently working as an EDI developer at Honeywell and has also recently got accepted into Duke University to pursue her master's in engineering management. So happy to have you with us today, Rashi.
Thank you so much, Jia, for introducing me, and I'm extremely happy to be here as well.
All right, so I'll start with my first question. So the change from school to college can be quite overwhelming and daunting. What was your experience as a fresher in college, and what were some of the difficulties that you faced?
So for me as a fresher, there were a number of things that were happening as soon as I came to VIT. There was literally no one that I knew of. So seeing unknown faces around me, using Google Maps to get my way to SJD, and keeping up with the digital assignments, the projects, and coming across so many people with varied perspectives changed my mind in the fresher year. I also realized that this place had a number of opportunities for me and had to make use of every opportunity. Talking to seniors, I also realized that VIT is a place which gives a lot of importance to academics. So I knew that I had to maintain a balance there. Coming to the things that I wish I knew before I started would be get into every experience possible. There are so many conferences, fests, and hackathons happening there. Engage yourself there. If you have the time and if you can commit there, go ahead. Talk to people around you. Make friends around you. There are people in VIT, they're always growing. They're working on continual improvement. Learn with them, speak to them, and have the best time. Also, when I reached in my last year, I realized that people were working on coding since their first year. Like, they were consistently improving there. So if you can begin with coding as early as possible, maybe just like do 10 questions every week and you'll be good to go. And enjoy while you learn. That's the most important thing. Like, VIT has a lot of opportunities, but it also gives you an idea of being responsible. So make use of that.
All right. My next question. You're currently working at Honeywell, with whom you've also done your internship. You've also done multiple other internships. How important do you think such internships are, and what do you look for while applying for internships?
Okay. So internships are extremely vital when it comes to deciding where does your passion lie, what do you think are the skills that are necessary for you to get ahead. Also, we're always around theoretical courses, like learning virtualization theoretically. We don't know how cloud actually works. So for me, basically, I was so interested when I picked up the course of virtualization that I wanted to do an internship which was based on cloud domain. So I went ahead with that and I realized my interest and passion for it. So a lot of things that come your way when it came to marketing, I wanted to do an internship in marketing. So they built my skills and my passion for it. Also, when you're doing an internship, you try to connect the theoretical world with the practical world. Like, that linkage is very important for you to understand where does your passion lie? How do you want your career to look like ahead? So those were the things that are necessary when you're doing an internship. Also, the things that I personally look for when I'm doing an internship is the kind of roles and responsibilities it has for me. What is the kind of environment that I'll be working in? What does the company do as a whole? So after a point of time, I realized that I wanted to venture into product-based companies because I wanted to know more on it. And also realizing the tools and the features that I'll be working with, because internship is a great platform for you to add new tools to your toolbox. So that was my take on it.
All right. What do you think are recruiters looking for while, you know, placements and all of that? And is it just your academics, or are there other skills that you need to develop on?
Okay, so I feel like academics does give you an edge when it comes to a good CGPA, and knowing proficient subjects like operating systems, networks and communication, data structures and algorithms, and database management systems. Also, with all these things, they want you to be very good with one of the skills. It could be application development. It could be one of the programming languages like Java, C++, any one language which you know well. Maybe you've done projects in that and you can easily solve. So those problem solving skills come along with it. But the package is definitely not complete without personal skills. People are looking, since you're working in a real world environment when you get into a job later on, they want you to be consistent. They want you to be accountable for the work that you're doing and meet the deadlines that they want you to with. Also, there's a lot of pressure that goes into place because you're working with the teams and, you know, you're accountable to so many people. You should be able to work in a pressurized environment. So that is what they're looking for.
All right. You've opted for a very unique course, that is engineering management. What was your inclination towards this particular field?
Okay, so for a year ago, I did not know what I wanted to do. I had entered Honeywell. I was working on this very niche environment called order to cash cycle. So this is where, you know, business and engineering aspect came closer. You know, I started to link those two things together. And even though I was good with the technicalities of it, I got stuck at places where business was linking with technical. And I was extremely getting curious, and it intrigued me how the linkages with management feels, with the strategy, with the operation and the marketing. It interested me. So I went further and I tried to work in an entrepreneurship-based research project where I was dealing with number of people who are trying to bring in their startups. So I came to know that, you know, product management and all these fields are of interest to me. When I was in college, I was also working on customer frontal roles. I was trying to take the lead when it came to projects. So when I analyzed all these things, I came across where my passion lies, what are the skills that I want, and engineering management seemed like a fit for me because all these things came as a package for me in engineering management. So, and looking at what I wanted to do ahead, getting into consultancy or product management roles and analytics, this is everything that engineering management provides you with. So it made my decision easier.
All right. Staying on the same topic, what made you zero in on Duke University?
So this was one of the most tough decisions of my entire journey. I had admits from Columbia, Duke, definitely, Johns Hopkins University, University of Southern California, and New York University. And they are recognized one of the best for Masters in Engineering Management. So picking up one university was very difficult because they were almost at par when it came to vast alumni and such vibrant alumni. I started speaking to people. I started to analyze where do I see myself in the next 5 years. And trust me, the community is so so helpful. I tried to connect with everybody on LinkedIn and they would reply to me within 1-2 days and tell me, answer my questions as to what I wanted to do. What are the things that the university provides with me? What are my expectations? What will their expectations be? What is the curriculum like? What are the courses like? And the kind of opportunities the alumni are engaged in now, and where do you see yourself? So that connection made it easier for me to decide where I wanted to be. And that's when I got zeroed down to Duke as my final university.
Okay. So while writing your resume or SOP, what are some of the things that you need to keep in mind?
So an SOP, I would highly recommend everyone to not read an SOP before you begin your first draft. Like, it's extremely necessary to be genuine in who you are, because believe in your story, write down the things that you've done professionally and personally, who you are as a person, and try to connect them with your purpose. For me, I was personally focusing on my past, present, and future. I tried to write down the experiences who have shaped my purpose. Like some of the experiences in my entrepreneurship internship or marketing internship or working on technical projects that shaped me for who I am today. And today when I'm working in a firm, how did it make me realize that, you know, engineering management is a fit for me, and how I look my future ahead? Maybe 2 years down the line, maybe 5 years down the line. So it helped me connect as to who I have been in the past and how I want to be in the future. Also keeping in mind where I am right now, and I do not want to settle here. There are a number of things that I want to improve at. So these were the few things that I mentioned. Also, it's extremely important for your first paragraph to stand out. Like, your first paragraph will develop the interest for the admissions committee. So work on that and work on the experiences that are extremely vital, because you have a word limit. There will be a number of color clubs, chapters, or experiences that you had, but focus on the most important ones that shaped you. That, you know, it's easier for them to connect with you in that case. So that was my take on it.
All right. What do you think of GRE scores and how necessary is preparation?
My take on GRE would be that practice well 3 months before you begin with GRE. Give a strong, focused environment to GRE, because that's what it requires. If you're beginning on early ahead, try to start reading newspaper like the New York Times, the Washington Post. They're a great method to improve your verbal skills. But that's not the end of it. I did not have the best GRE score. I had a good quantitative score, which was a 167 on 170, but my verbal was a low, which was 148. I knew I had to make up for all these things in my SOP and LOR. So I tried to work on it. I tried to reiterate it. But GRE, again, is not the end of it. The admissions committee is definitely looking for your profile holistically. They want you to be great in all the things. So it's just a part of it. Make your best use of it. Try to work on the Magoosh app. Try to work on the GregMat. They are great platforms to get your GRE ahead and get a good score. But it also depends on you, your profile, and they are looking for a profile which is holistically great and fits for their program, your purpose, your LORs, and all the other essays that come along with it. So yeah.
Everyone is very fixated on having the perfect resume. Do you think it's necessary to only focus on accomplishing the things that look good on your resume?
Oh, so for me, 2 years ago, I did not know that what a resume should look like. What are the things that I am going to be doing that would make my resume look appealing? For me, the best thing that happened was I was extremely restless to know what I'm going to be doing in the future. I was not content with what I was doing right now. So I was constantly looking for opportunities around me, trying to work on different things and the things that I like. It's not necessary for a resume to look like someone else's. Try to show the things that you like. What are your passions? What does your interest like? And try to work on those things. There's so many opportunities around you. Do not look at anyone else. You have your own journey and make your resume around that. When I was not happy with where I am, I tried to indulge in a number of different courses, in a number of different experiences, club experiences, projects, which made it easy for me to find out where I want to be rather than looking at someone else's resume or what would look appealing. Also, VIT is great when it comes to motivating you to get a 9-pointer. So I knew that I did not want to lose on my 9-pointer and go for classes and get stuck over there. So I was automatically working on my academics to maintain the 9-pointer. So my profile or my resume maybe seemed appealing to them because all these things that I'd worked on was for me and not for the resume to look nice. So yeah, that was my take.
Okay. We have multiple projects throughout our tenure in VIT, and not everyone gives 100% for these projects. How important do you think these projects are?
Oh yeah, so there's a thing in VIT where, you know, we try to get out of projects, we try a shortcut out of it, but projects are extremely important. They shape you in way not your theoretical courses can. First of all, when it comes to masters, they're particularly looking for people who are good as leaders and who have worked in a team environment. So there's a work ethic that you develop when you're working on various projects. And, you know, there's a deep learning that comes into picture. There's nobody to spoon feed you. There's professional feedback that comes into place. There are teachers who are working with you. There are others who are working with you. And they are trying to help you with it. But it's you who try to deliver the project with your team. So these things, they develop you in a way that theoretical courses cannot. So try to focus on them. If coding is not meant for you, why not try designing? Why not try what are the other things that you can develop the product at what you're working on? So such things, they develop you. So even like that, there were people who worked on projects which turned out great and they tried to convert that into research papers, which is a great add-on to what you're doing. And even recruiters are looking for how you are when it comes to projects and how you are with linking your skills to real world, how you're making use of those skills when it comes to practicality. So it gets easier over there.
All right. Now for my last question, coming back to the application process, what are some of the things that can be done to make your entire application process a little more smoother and well-informed?
Okay. So coming to that, I knew my application would not stand out without doing extra effort. So I tried to create a website CV which showed who I am as a person. And I created an introduction video, added the various things that I had done in the past. And it was basically my portfolio out there. So maybe it helped the admission committee to connect with me more and try to analyze who I am as a person. And also to, as you asked me, to make ourselves more well-informed, there are great platforms like YourKit and the Grad Cafe. There are admitted students or people who are trying to get admitted constantly posting over there to keep you informed on where their application status is like, if the university has responded to them yet. So it keeps you more informed. Third of all, I know that, you know, the application process seems tedious from the outside. And, you know, there are a number of things that we have to work on. There is the SOP that you have to work on. Some people are asking you to work on essays. You have to keep track if your LORs have been submitted by your supervisors. So I would say a very easy tool to work on it would be Excel. Try to jot down all the universities who would be applying for 5 to 7 universities. Try to jot down where your application is at there. What are the prompts that they are looking for? The university would be looking for prompts, right? Like there would be things that the university wants you to mention in the essay. Try to write all those things down in an Excel sheet in a very well-formatted form so that you know where you are, what are the things that you have to work on, what are the deadlines, and by when you have to work on what parts of the application. So it makes your task much more easier. So yeah, I think, and also people feel that applications are very tedious. Trust me, it's not. It's just the self-reflection journey. And make the most of it. I personally enjoyed every day of my application process. So these days, don't come back and make the most of it. And all the best to everyone who's applying over there.
Thank you so much, Rashi. It was a very great and insightful conversation that we had today.
Thank you so much, Ria.
Thank you.
Thank you.